Hey everybody, Renegade410 here again with another quick gear review. In one of my previous videos, I mentioned how I usually have a pen on me, especially when I'm at work. I have a couple of them. When I'm out and about, I have that little EDC pen attached to my wallet chain. And I mentioned that I like having my own pen, using my own pen for a number of different reasons. I don't want to be touching everybody's, someone else's pen that's been all over the place and stuff like that. I don't want to be catching a cold or anything from anybody like that. But I did mention that I had a couple of pens, and this is one of them. I mentioned that I had a pen from an uncle that is a retired police officer. That's not this one. This is the Surefire pen that I was talking about. I purchased this pen a couple months ago. Been carrying it every day at work. Writes great. It feels great in the hand. I really like it. This is definitely one pen that I do not lend out to anyone. If somebody asks to borrow a pen, I usually give them one of the cheaper backup pens that I carry. But let's get down into the pen. This is, as I said, and you can see it right there if we focus. This is a Surefire pen. This is the first version of their pen. They do now make a second version, the Surefire Pen 2, which is a click pen. This one's not. This one we activate by twisting down. The tip pops out of the point here. Twist it back, and it retracts back into the housing. It's a great pen. I like it. It's got a good feel, like I said. It's a little bit bigger than the pens I'm usually used to using. I like skinnier pens, but this also has a couple of good features that I'll talk about that I like, and I think it's a good idea, and that's why it's a little bit chunkier, a little bit easier to hold on to. The specs on this pen, real quick, we'll go over to Surefire's website right here. The overall length on the pen, I'm gonna guess they mean with the housing fully closed, so that the point of the ink cartridge is extended, is 6.04 inches. The weight overall is 1.08 ounces, and it actually comes with an ink cartridge already with the pen when you get it, and this is a Schmidt Easy Flow 9000 as per Surefire's website. The pen itself is of an aerospace grade aluminum that's hard anodized. This one in black. They do make it in a couple other colors. I believe the other colors are blue and, let's check the website, yep, blue and tan, so it's black, blue, and tan for the colors. Pretty much, I think they bill it exactly as it is. They say it's pretty much, indestructible, and I think they're basically right. The body, as I said, is aluminum. The tip, I guess you want to call that the pommel end or the top end of it, and this clip are all stainless steel, all very durable. I haven't had to use this in any kind of defensive or any capacity like that yet, and I hope I don't have to, but I believe that, if you had to, if this is what you happen to have in your hand and somebody tried to attack you or something, believe me, with this aluminum body and that stainless steel tip or the stainless steel end here, you're gonna have a pretty good improvised weapon if you need to. As it says, this is made in the USA. Like I said, I like it. I think it's a great pen. I've been using it for a while, and the only thing I think I'm going to need to do is probably just get a replacement ink cartridge, because I do use it pretty much constantly while I'm at work. Another great little feature about this pen is the way Surefire thought to add a little something more to just their pen. This end can be used. This is a stainless steel ball bearing in there. It doesn't move around or anything, but it is a ball bearing, or at least it appears to be. This can be used as an emergency glass breaker. If you're stuck in a car, or you need to get someone who's stuck in a car out, and the only way to get them out of there is through one of the safety glass windows, the side windows, or the rear window of that vehicle, you can take this, ball it up in your hand, and pop that window out. I have not used this particular item to break a window. I do have a knife that I carry on patrol every day with me that I've used when I'm patrol, when I'm in uniform, that I've used to actually pull people out of vehicles. I've had to break a couple of car windows to get two people and get into the vehicles. When a person in need of medical attention, another person that was just in a car accident and was stuck inside the vehicle, I needed to get in there. And I have broken the safety glass with another piece of equipment, a knife, and I'll do a review on that. But you can probably, I would bet that you could use that to break the glass, and it wouldn't be a problem. I would suggest, like anything else, if it's an emergency, it's an emergency. But try and get your hand far enough away from that so you don't go through and get yourself cut up on any of the glass. Well, use a glove. But sometimes, as when I had to do it, there wasn't time for that. You just had to do what you had to do, and it worked out, which was a really good thing. Like I said, it's a nice pen. It is a little bit heavier than what I'm used to. It's a little bit thicker than what I'm used to. But it feels good. I like it. It's got this, it's like a triangular shape to the lower portion of it, which is good for the way I write. I grip nice. It writes well. When it's all the way closed here, it's balanced very nice. It sits nicely in my hand, and I can write. I've written reports. I've written all kinds of things with this. It's great. I don't have a problem with it at all. It's heavy enough that it's there. You're not gonna lose. It's big enough too to know that it's there, and you're not gonna be afraid of that you may have lost it. The only downside that I see to the pen is, again, its size. It doesn't really fit all that well in some of the pen pockets that I have on a couple of my shirts. So that may or may be, may be an issue for you, may not be. For me, it's not that big of an issue. As I said in one of my previous videos, I have a custom carrier for my concealable body armor that I take this, I slip it in a pocket. It works great. I don't have a problem with it. Like I said, I think it's a great addition to my work equipment. I carry it every day, need a pen at work all the time. This is one of those ones that I carry. I carry this one for myself. I do carry another one as a backup for me in case I do run out of ink, which hopefully I won't. I'm gonna get a replacement cartridge soon and use that, just keep that with me in case this does run out. But then I carry another one in case my partner loses his, and I carry another pen to give to the people filling out or signing, filling out a statement or signing their statement or a report, so I don't have to give them this. I really don't want to lose this. As per Surefire's website, it's $125 for any one of the three colors. The black, as you see here, the blue, which if you check out their website is, I guess you could call it, maybe like a titanium blue. And then a tan, which kind of looks like a light coyote or a light desert tan. From the pictures on their website, anyway. I haven't seen them. This is the one I wanted. This is the one I liked. I like the black. It's good for everything. I don't have to worry about it being too flashy or anything like that. It's great for work. Great for carry. Again, I use this at work just because I need something good at work. And it does add a little bit of extra utility, having, a way maybe to break some auto glass. The fact that it's very, very strong. This is a rock solid pen. You're not going to damage any of this stuff short of probably crushing it with a truck. But that's about it. I think it's great. And if you're in the market for a really nice, tough, strong pen that does add some extra defensive capability, like I said, it's heavy enough that you could use it, or add some utility. Guys out there, it's law enforcement, military, EMS, fire, if you guys need something, sometimes you never know. You got to get into that window. You know how it is out there, guys. And that might be just the thing that's on you, and you got to use it. It's also great for an EDC pen. It's a little big, I think, but if you're going to carry a full-size pen around anyway, why not go for something that's tough and adds those extra little bits to your EDC, the defensive capability and the utility, besides just being a pen. But that's about all I got for now, guys. I'm going to try and get this up there real soon. And I hope you like it. If you got comments, let me know. If you want to know more, if you didn't like something, hey, let me know too. All right, guys. You stay safe out there.